Well, I had graduated from college, Boston University Fine Arts School.
Oh.
And I immediately got a job in a regional theater in Theater Atlanta.
Uh-huh.
Some producers saw it and picked it up and transported all of us to New York. And I thought, wow, this is easy. Everybody at home said it would be hard to become a working actress, and here I am on Broadway yeah. right away. And after 41 performances, we closed. So I got to watch the first season of Sesame Street mm-hmm. and Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, because Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood would make me feel better about myself being an unemployed actress. And Sesame Street would cheer me up.
Uh-huh.
I'd just begun to start, you know, looking for work in New York. And people would always say, you have an interesting voice. And they said, do you want to do voiceovers? So I started getting voiceovers and stuff. And so when I watched Sesame Street, I thought, gee, I wonder if they need anybody to do voices, because they were animated clips that were inserted into the show. I wasn't really thinking about doing puppet voices, but coincidentally, there was an ad in backstage saying that Jim Henson was looking to train puppeteers for an upcoming Ed Sullivan Christmas special. I thought, wow, you know, this could be a laugh. I literally called the Jim Henson company, and somewhere in there, Jim got on the phone. And I said, hi, I'm an actress, and I wondered if I could, you know, do voices. And he said, well, we don't do it that way. The puppeteers do their own voices. And I said, oh, geez, you know, I've never played with a puppet in my life, you know, and it's true, I just never had one as a toy. He said, well, you know, we'll set up an audition or whatever, come over for a meeting within a couple of weeks. And I think the main reason that he paid any attention was the fact that I had this acting background. And he knew that he didn't know anything about puppets until he decided he wanted to be a puppeteer. So he, I guess, in his mind, allowed the fact that somebody might come in who could learn how to puppeteer as he did. So anyway, there was Frankie and a floor-to-ceiling mirror and a big box of puppets. And somehow in my mind, I didn't even think this was an audition. It just was so relaxed and loosey-goosey, and Jim was so low-key, and, you know, there were some scripts, as I recall. I think Jim said, well, you know, try on a puppet or two, and I reached into this box, and it was like, oh, my God, I'm auditioning for Frank and Jim, and, you know, all of a sudden it did feel like a big deal. But I think I had a little bit of a knack, as you did. And I came up with some characters, and I remember we improvised off these scripts, but it just seemed very easy and fun and no big whoop. And I think I wasn't nervous because I didn't want to be a puppeteer. I'm an actress.
Yeah,
I'm just
yeah.
doing this to
so it's better
fill
if you
in.
Don't care,
it's
yeah.
better than modeling bras at Lady Marlene. I did the workshop, then I did the Ed Sullivan Christmas show. I think I was a Frackle or something.
Yeah, in Toronto.
In Toronto. And then when that shoot was over, Jim asked if we wanted to do Sesame Street. And I said, oh my gosh, you know, this is fun and it's great, but you know, I'm an actress, I want my face to be seen. And he said, well, you know, just try it or whatever. And
Jim's
I mean,
always, well, it's fun.
Yeah, it was just yeah. so.
He never tried to hold on to people.
Never.
No,
never.
No,
he
it was
trusted
just,
that it would all work out.
And boy, yeah. Yeah, you're absolutely right. So I found myself on Sesame Street, you know, having just graduated from college, really, a year later.